Having looked at what a 2D array is, let's now have a look at how we can iterate through them, which is one of the key ways we use 2D arrays in programs. So, I'm going to start with the kind of bad news first, or the nasty bit of code first. Here is how we potentially iterate through a 2D array. There we go. There's the slightly nasty code. So, if I want to iterate through it, iterating through it is just a way of saying I want to check every element. We could also say looping through it. I'm going through every element in this 2D array, which is more complicated in a 2D array because we've got to go through not only each element in the array itself, but also within each element, within each of our array elements, if that makes sense. So we've got in this scores 2D array, I've got 1, 2, 3, 4 elements, but of course each one is also an array. So I've got to look inside each of those arrays to get all of those elements as well. Normally we solve this using nested for loops. Nesting is where we have one block of code inside another block of code. We can see I've got an outer for loop here, and I've also got an inner for loop inside it. So how does this code work? Well, we hopefully recognize the structure of this outer for loop. This is the exact same way we iterate through a 1D array. So I is set to be 0, I is representing our index number, and we keep looping until we hit our length -1. It's got to be -1 because we don't want to overshoot and go beyond the indices we have. The thing which is clearly different is our inner for loop here. So this time round, conventionally we use the letter J. We can't use the letter I again because I is already being used for one of our index numbers. We need to use J because I also have a second index number when I've got a 2D array. If I'm trying to go within each array within my 2D array, I need to use two index numbers, and we can see when I'm actually indexing my 2D array, I'm now using two index numbers, both I and J. Now, like I, J is set to 0 initially because we want to go through every index. This time around, the scores length, or the length of scores, isn't the length of the 2D array itself, it's the length of that particular array within scores. So initially, I is going to be 0 the first time this runs, J is going to be 0. So we're doing scores index 0 dot length -1. So what that is, scores index 0 is referring to this array within the scores 2D array. So we're going, what is the length of this? Well, the length is 3 minus 1 is 2. So really that is replaced with 2. The first time this inner for loop runs, we're going to print scores index I, which is 0, comma J, where J is currently 0 as well. And scores index 0, comma 0 is going to give us 17. So we would print out 17 because 17 is our first item. Now the way nested for loops work is this inner for loop needs to complete before we go back and iterate our outer for loop. So I won't change here because I'm not done with J. J will now become 1. The length still stays the same, but I'm going to now be printing scores index 0 because I hasn't changed, comma 1. Scores index 0, comma 1 is going to give us 19 this time. J then increments, so J is now going to be 2. The length hasn't changed. We're now going to print 0, comma 2, which is going to give us 21. And now, because this bit here said that we're going up to 2 and including 2, because J is now effectively 3, we now leave this inner for loop and we go back round to the next I. So now I was 0, I is now equal to 1. And inside our inner for loop, J is now reset to 0. And the length actually hasn't changed. So we're now looking at scores index 1. And scores index 1 refers to this particular array within scores. Now, in the 2D arrays you are going to see in the exam, I imagine all of the arrays within the 2D array are going to be the same length. This doesn't always happen in reality. Occasionally, each array within the outer array can be different lengths, which is why this code is really important. Typically, I think your code will always be the same length, but I could be wrong. This code will work no matter whether these are all length 3 or some are length 2, some are length 5, and it varies. In this code, this is still going to give us 2 because the length is 3 minus 1 is 2. So the first time this print line runs, I is now 1, J is now back to 0, scores index 1, comma 0 is going to refer to 14. So we print 14, J then becomes 1, we now print 1, comma 1. This is now going to be 25 and so on and so on. So when I run it, we just get all of our elements printed out one by one. in the order in which they are presented in the 2D array. It is important we understand this outer for loop refers to each 1D array in the 2D array, and the inner for loop refers to each element in those 1D arrays. And the inner for loop will always complete until the next I is looked at. Now this code just prints out all of the elements, which is often not what we have to do. Often we have to do some processing with it. So we often just adapt this for loop structure. And this particular for loop structure is only used when we want to go through every single element in your 2D array. So here, if I'm trying to find the mean average of this 2D array, here I want to go through every element. So I want to find the average of every element in this 2D array. That's why I need to use this slightly complicated nested for loop code. We'll look at an example in a second where actually you don't have to check every element, so therefore the code becomes a little bit simpler. This is our kind of worst case scenario where I've got to go through every single element. So it's the same for loop structure for I equals 0 to scores.length minus 1, then for j equals 0 to scores index i.length minus 1. The same nested for loops, except this time I'm not just printing, I'm using the element. So I'm using the same indexing I used just now, where we're using both I and j to index our 2D array. I'm adding it to a total. I'm also keeping track of how many I've got. So I'm adding to a count as well, because to find the mean average, we need to do the total divided by the count. Hopefully you can see how I've just adapted the code I just had to use the same indexing to make sure I can add up every single element in this array. And I'm also keeping track of the count. It is important you understand this double for loop structure because you could need it in a tricky question. That being said, actually a lot of the time, that questions on 2D arrays don't actually require that double for loop structure. They might still require one for loop, but because they're not checking every single element or because there's a predictable pattern, you maybe don't need that double for loop structure. So this is an example of where this is the case. I've got a 2D array called countries. I've got the country, I've got the capital, I've got the population of the country as items or elements in these arrays. I want to ask the user to enter a country. Then I want to print out the capital city and then the population of that country. So how am I going to solve this problem? Well, first of all, I can ask the user to enter a country, that's easy. But my approach is going to be to iterate through each of our arrays within countries, check to see if the first element is equal to what the user typed in. So did the user type in UK? No. Did they type in Iceland? No. Did they type in Portugal? Yeah. Then once I've found that array, I can then just index element 1 in that array and element 2 in that array. So here's how it might look. We're asking for the country, that's fairly standard. I've only got one for loop here because, like I say, I don't need to necessarily go into every element in my inner arrays. I can just index them directly. So this for loop is enabling me to go through each of my arrays within countries, because we need to check to see whether the first index equals what the user typed in. I'm going through each of these. But what I'm not doing is I'm not using a second for loop to go through each item inside each array, because I don't need to here. I can just index it. I'm checking to see whether index 0 of that array is equal to what the user typed in. If it is, then I just need to print index 1 of that array and then index 2 of that array. So if I run the code and type in Iceland, it will first of all be checking index 0, which is going to be this array. That doesn't get matched up. Then it will check the second array and the first index will equal Iceland. So we print out Reykjavik and 400,000. If I type in a country not here, then it won't be able to find it because it's not matching up. So it's not giving us anything at all. But it is still iterating through each of our arrays within the 2D array. So 2D arrays are more confusing. You only need to use that double for loop structure when you are going through every single element systematically. Here, I've got a clear pattern. For capital is always index 1, population is always index 2. Therefore, I don't need to go through every single element. My code can be made a little bit more simple. So don't try and overcomplicate it. Take a second to think, is every element being checked? If not, then you could potentially just index it, although you may still need to have an outer for loop.